How to get the most out of YouTube analytics. Don't look at your YouTube analytics. Every minute you spend looking at those is time you could spend working on your next project or time you could spend relaxing. And both of those are infinitely better use of your time and infinitely better for your mental health. The only entity they serve is YouTube itself, as they train you to be an obedient cog in the corporate machine that YouTube is. The worst offender is all this bullshit right here, on YouTube Studio, the new page that they forced on everyone with a channel, whether they wanted it or not. And nobody wanted it. They put it in a place where you see it every time you go into YouTube Studio, so you have no choice but to look at it, and no, there's no way to hide it. I censored the black numbers because they are besides the point. I want you to look at the readable red numbers on the side. The first problem is that they're red. Red is bad. You did a bad thing. You got 9% less views, people watched your videos for 18% less, and you made 41% less money. Now you might wonder, 9%, 18%, 40% of what? Well, compared to what you did in the previous period of 28 days. These numbers are deceptive and manipulative in two ways. The first is that they are not actual decreases, it's a slowdown of growth, but it's growth nonetheless. I didn't lose views, watch time, or revenue, I just gained less than I did in the last 28 days. I still have more views, more watch time, and more revenue than I did before. The red and the arrows make it look like I lost out, but in reality, I haven't lost anything. The second and more important deception about these numbers is that they seem to judge you, but a lot of these numbers are beyond your control. A reduction in growth is not your fault, or at the very least, it's not your fault alone. Remember that the YouTube algorithm is what decides who watches your videos. At any time, YouTube can decide to take a video of yours and shove it down anyone's throat. If enough people click on it, it creates a snowball effect where a video suddenly explodes in views, regardless of how much effort you put into it. If YouTube wants your videos to be a success, it can make it so. But when it doesn't, it tells you you didn't do a good job. I'm not saying that success on YouTube is completely beyond your control. Don't go blaming everything on them. It's always a good idea to make sure your videos and thumbnails are visually appealing, that the audio is clear and balanced, all that basic stuff. But just because your analytics aren't going up as much doesn't mean you've done something wrong. Let me tell you why my analytics are in the red. That's because these are my January analytics. The month before January is December. December is the holiday season. That's when companies spend all their budget on advertising. And after December, they're all dried up and ad revenue goes down before it slowly climbs back up again in a couple months after. That's just how it is. And that dip goes for everyone, but then I also started streaming Final Fantasy VII in January. Playing Final Fantasy means Square Enix goes for a copyright claim on all of my streams, since they own the rights to all the music and they want to show it. In addition, I'm not a Final Fantasy channel, I'm a Fire Emblem channel, so people who are only here for Fire Emblem aren't going to watch me play Final Fantasy. That means I get less viewers. There are also other factors at play here. In December, I probably released a couple of videos that were really popular, whereas in January I didn't do as much. I have not been able to release a long scripted video in a while, since they're still in the works, and I haven't started a new Let's Play in a while. Both of those usually bring me a big boost in views, and they'll happen eventually, but they didn't in January. During January, I mostly uploaded Let's Plays and tier lists, videos that have a stable amount of views. All this is stuff I already knew. Without spending 1 second in analytics looking for drop-off rates, or retention time, or click-through rates, or whatever. Would I like these stable videos to have more views? Sure, I love attention like anyone else, and I'm not going to pretend I don't get a dopamine boost from seeing a video skyrocket in views, but that's not a realistic expectation. Episode 37 of a Let's Play isn't suddenly going to get a bunch of people watching it. And that's fine. I know these are not videos made for mass appeal, but that is part of the appeal for me, because I know that even though it's only a fraction of my subscriber base that watches these episodes, I know that those that do are my most dedicated subs, and they're willing to listen to me talk about anything or play any game. Some of them might have watched every single video I've made. Some of them might be my patrons, or loyal stream watchers, or people that hang out in my Discord. I don't make videos for YouTube analytics or the algorithm. I make videos for people that get joy out of them. I'm incredibly fortunate that people watch what I make at all. YouTube analytics does a great job at cloaking individual people and their enjoyment through numbers. Let's say your video was enjoyed by only 10 people. That's still a room full of people. I don't know about you, but if I'm in a room with 10 people and I say something that makes them all laugh, that feels really good. And if I was a comedian or a filmmaker or an artist and the same 10 people came back to see what I've created every time, I'd be honored that all these people are so loyal to me. YouTube analytics would be like, 10 people, fuck you, that's only a 0% increase, do better. I say, fuck YouTube analytics, you don't know what you're talking about. In the future, if you ever find yourself agonizing over YouTube analytics, remember this video, maybe watch it again if you feel like it, that's what I plan on doing. And if you know a friend who is, maybe consider sharing this video with them.